Hello. In this video, I want to talk about how much internet a typical household family might need. So I have two main providers in my area. I have Mediacom and CenturyLink, and I want to look at what they are offering on the website here. I haven't punched my address in, but I was able to pull this up. So they have internet 60, internet 100, internet 200, and internet 500 and gigabyte at Mediacom. And then CenturyLink has this up to 20 megabit, 40 to 80 megabit and 100 to 140 megabit service. I do know they put fiber in here, so I could get gigabit at my house. I don't see it on here, but that doesn't really matter for what I'm talking about. If you're a power user, what I'm talking about here is probably irrelevant. If you download super large files all the time, you probably already know what you need for internet, but this is just someone who's just starting out in a new area, needs to get internet. How much should they get? One place to look here is Netflix has this help file and it says internet speed recommendations, and they say you have to have a half megabit is required, and then 1.5 megabits is recommended, and 3 megabits recommended for SD, 5 megabits recommended for HD, and 25 megabits recommended for Ultra HD. So I think most people are going to fall into this 5 megabit category. So it's 5 megabits per second recommended for HD content. That's very common on Netflix. If we go over to Vudu, you'll see something kind of similar. It says SD requires 1 megabit, HD requires 4.5 megabit, and UHD requires 11 megabit. Here again, 5 megabits kind of a target. When you're looking at internet speed, you really want to consider video, because text, like email text, downloading pictures, social networking, that stuff is going to be lower bandwidth consumption than video. Video is going to take up the most. So what I tend to like to recommend is you get about 5 megabits per person in the household that could potentially be streaming video at the same time, or internet users in general. If you have a household of 4 and you have 2 parents, a teenager, and maybe like a 3-year-old, so then you have 3 people that are probably using the internet somewhat regularly. I recommend about 5 megabits per person, and then add 5 on top just for extra breathing room. So for 3 people, I would recommend getting at least 20 megabit download speed. If we look here at the marketing here, we have internet 60. It says stream music, download files, and surf web up to 2 to 4 devices at a time. If we go to 100, it says 4 to 6 devices at a time. Internet 200 says 6 to 8, and internet 500 says 8 to 12, and gigabit, it says it's perfect speed for everyone in your home. Doesn't give a speed. So let's look at internet 500. Well, when we looked at Netflix, it said you need 5 megabits to download HD video. So here it says this is for 8 to 12 people. So if we take 12 times 5, we're getting 60. If you look here, the lowest is 60. So in perfect situation, like if you could get that full 60, this should be plenty to download HD streams for those 12 people. You know, the marketing here, they act like you need this 500 megabit to do that. Well, you don't. The 60 would be fine. Although if you had 12 people, you might want to bump up to the 100 just for some breathing room. It's not, I'm talking about kind of the minimums you'd want to get. The same here. We look, it says up to 100 megabit to connect multiple users and 10 plus devices. Same thing here. So, you know, a household of 4, you know, I said would probably want 20 megabit, but you look here, the price, they have this deal where you can get 40 to 80. So I would go with the 40 to 80 there. And maybe if you really have a tough budget and it's cheaper to get the 20, you could start with the 20. One thing to consider is you might ask when you're ordering it, how hard it is to upgrade. So you can start with a minimum, start at 20. And then if that doesn't work, go up to the next level in your area, because everyone's going to have different plans, I'm sure, for that. Another thing to consider is latency. Like if you're a gamer, you want high, lower latency, which is the time to connect to sites. And that's hard to judge. I don't see that advertised a lot on these. You can probably go to sites online. They might have ratings for which internet is good for gaming. So that might be something to look into. Another thing to consider is that the site you're connecting to may be overwhelmed and you might not get the speed. So say you have 5 megabits dedicated to Netflix. Well, if Netflix was overwhelmed, or that the backbone can't handle your 5 megabit, it doesn't matter that you have the 5 megabit. The other end needs to be able to handle the speed you have. So if you can't get fast internet where you live, so say you're in a rural area and you can get 5 megabit, I wouldn't rule out streaming. Well, I'd rule out streaming maybe. You could probably stream one stream pretty good, maybe a low res stream. But something to consider is to get a tablet. Like I use an iPad, and all the apps, all the big apps like Vudu, Netflix and such, you can download your movies. So what you could do is you could set that to download at night and then watch it the next day. That's an option for you. Another thing would be video podcasts. I don't know how popular those are. They used to be pretty popular. You can download different things like that. This was a quick video I wanted to make on internet speed because I know a lot of times people get these mailers, I get them all the time in the mail, that say you get some fast streaming, get this gigabit service or whatever. Well, you don't really need that, and you know, it's right here in this Netflix page. I'll put a link to this in the description too, so you know, if you're ever trying to figure out what you need, you can reference this. So well, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you have any tips or you know, related to this, go ahead and add those in the comments also. And if you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do that. And thanks for watching. Goodbye.